Okay, here's this massive head frame. That's one of the tallest ones I think I've ever seen. And comes down over here and goes down even down there. And then over here, this is really interesting. There's a huge nest right there. We saw some owls fly out of the shaft here, so that might be some kind of owl nest. And then right up here is another nest. Okay, here's a shot looking up this inclined shaft to the surface, to the head frame. And you can see there how the rails were attached to these two big beams here. The rails are missing right here, but you can see them further up there. And the ore cart would have gone up on these tracks. It would have been hoisted up from the inclined shaft here, which continues down that way. And you can see the rails pick up again right there. And this section right here is like a little drawbridge with this piece of curved ore cart track. What this was they would have an ore cart that was coming back down the shaft, but wanted to get off here and take these tracks into that drift tunnel that bends off to the right into that stope over there. They would have lowered this section of track down, and then it would have caught the ore cart coming down, and the cart would have came down and went right across the bridge that way instead of continuing on down the inclined shaft. So that's what that was used for. And you can see the cable there, right there in the center, that would have been used to raise and lower that section of track. And then over here is the manway with the ladders. And those go down a couple hundred feet. And there's water down there. Graham's already gone down there and checked it out, and there is water. There is a drift tunnel, though, before the water that heads off to the right down there and connects up with that stope I showed you earlier, that big cavernous stope that's behind this rock wall here. I noticed here on the inclined shaft are some of these insulators that were used for the electrical wiring that ran up and down the shaft. There's some more up there and right there, and some on top there. Okay, we're directly underneath this quarry, which is a little unnerving because the ceiling probably isn't that thick, I'm guessing. And up here, looks like it might have collapsed or caved in. Wow, oh my gosh. You're right, this is huge. I did not see this. That goes way down there. So it just came from that way, and here is looking down with some illumination, and you can see down there a tunnel continuing in this huge stope. And over here is more tunneling, and then some dugouts up there in the ceiling. Two big dugouts. And right here at the top of the ladder system, you can see one of those trap doors that's open right now, but they could close that, and they would close the one back there. It's already closed. That way they could walk across this gap if they wanted to head back that way towards that other tunnel there that curves off to the right. So that's another example of the trap doors that were used in the manways. Pretty cool.
Down from the stope. Down there is where they found the rabbit. And this is one day worship.
Okay, so we're about 3,500 feet in from the portal, and we found this rabbit barely alive, probably dying of thirst down in this stope. We're looking down from a drift level, and he's way down there, and obviously can't find his way back out, and just end up dying in here. And we just came from that way, through that timbered arch. We're at a major intersection here in this particular mine, and another incline shaft is right here in front of us. There's the manway, the ladder, and then here on the right is the tracks for the ore cart. So we're going to head down there and check this one out. So here at the top of the incline shaft on the ore cart tracks is this metal device that goes up and down like this. And we think what that was when an ore cart came up, was hauled up the shaft, it would pass over that and push it down. And then once it passed over it, it would pop back up like that. And that would prevent the ore cart from rolling back down the incline shaft. It's like a safety device, like a braking mechanism. And then of course the ore cart would take off and follow the tracks through the mine that way. Okay, that's how far down I've come, not very far. And you can see here the what's left of the ore cart tracks, how they're supported by wooden timbers like that. And then these big cross timbers. And then I'm headed down that way, the rest of the incline. Not sure how far down this goes, but let's go check it out. Okay, still making my way down a little bit closer. It looks like right down there, it looks like it might drop off and become much more vertical. So we'll carefully go down this last section of ladder here and see what's down there. And here's a shot looking back up. Come down just a little further than I was the last time. Okay, you're looking down there at the bottom of the incline. Gets a little bit steeper there, that last section. And there's the bottom, and there's no drift tunnels down there. I can tell by looking down there, there's nothing. It's just a sump. And that big pipe there, that tube, was the ventilation tubing. Still hanging there, and then coming over here where it's fallen. What they were after was this stope that goes up into there. And you can see some timbering and a ladder in there. But I'm not going to climb up in there. It's a little too crazy. But yeah, that's the bottom of the incline, and here's a shot looking up. That's looking up to the top there, where Graham is. So here at the bottom of this incline shaft in the overhead, you can see some rock bolts there, triangle-shaped plate with a bolt in there and pieces of wood behind that, which I don't think I've ever seen before. I've seen rock bolts before, but never reinforced with timbering like that. You can see all the wedges they put in there. There's three of them, one there, and then one down there. And then there's some big support timbers right there.